Right, so first stage is drilling a pilot hole in the wall with the SDS bit, marking out the centre position of the back box. Then we need to drill the other two pilot holes for the template. Then we need to remove the bulk of the material using the round cutter in the outer two pilot holes. So now we've got that round, that figure of eight I was speaking about. That was a hard material. So we'd have to use the SDS shank chisel just to take the corners out instead of using the square cutter. Because this is breeze block, we can use the double square cutter. What I am going to have to do though is clear out the centre pilot drill with this again, because the debris from the round cutter has filled up the pilot hole. Clear that out. The square cutter in. And as I said, the centre portion does just spin. So if we leave rotation on the power tool, the centre portion will spin, and once that starts to bite into the wall, it won't skip round. But I always find it easier if we turn rotation off and just use the hammer action. Drop that into the pilot hole, square it up on the wall as best you can, and then allow the hammer action of the power tool to take it into the wall. Then what we get is a perfect double square hole. Pop in your back box in. Obviously you have to have a power tool where you can turn the rotation off, because we're chiseling down there. It'd be no good if you leave the rotation off. It's not really going to help. So we turn the rotation off. Just use the chiseling function. Yeah.